national championship. The Florida Gators have won the Southeastern Conference championship.
GatorZone is presented by Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of GatorZone. Jeff Cardozo here with you, with a guy you don't normally get to see. He's on the other side, but excited to be working with Mr. Gareth Gutierrez.
That's right, Megan's on assignment this week, so here I am. I don't get paired with you very often. No. I think really the only time I normally get paired with you is when we're in Omaha, and you know what? We're out here at baseball because baseball season right around the corner.
That it is, and the Gators make Omaha their summer home, basically. They've been 4 years in a row, so trying to make it five, and what Kevin O'Sullivan has done here has been absolutely phenomenal, but they lose some phenomenal guys. A lot of first-rounders, a lot of studs, but some new studs coming in. Let's find out who they are.
After the season ended, I went up to the Cape and played up there for a summer, and that was a really cool experience. And then, you know, getting back for the fall, we had the new guys come in, of course, and it was a lot of fun getting acclimated to them and just teaching them the process of how we do things around here. And here we are, close to the season. I'm excited.
You know, this group of guys is really special. I love each and every one of them. You know, they're great teammates. They have great attitudes, and they love hustling on and off the field.
I expect to see young guys coming in guns blazing. You know, they're going to come in here and compete. They're not going to be scared of the bright lights, and, you know, that's something good to see. You know, they're a bunch of good kids, and it's weird being the older guy. You know, I'm used to being the young guy that, you know, coming in here and trying to prove myself, and, you know, I'm going in this year proving the same thing. But, you know, I gotta lead these young guys, and, you know, I'm happy to do it. I love talking to those guys and being a leader to them.
The starting of August, it was a big adjustment coming from high school to college, getting along with guys that I'm now on the bottom of the totem pole and they're at the top with a lot older guys, and the team chem, I feel like I've really adjusted and gotten pretty close to some of the guys.
I think they've done really well. The team we have now, just with the new guys, is kind of just meshed together, and I think we're flowing as one as much as any team that I've been a part of while I've been here. So it's good. I think we're going to have a really good shot to play really well this year.
I think our pitching depth is really a lot better this year, and I think that we're going to use a lot of guys throughout the season. And I think the freshmen are really acclimated to Florida and how the SEC works.
Oh, I'm pumped. You know, this is my last go around, so I'm trying to make the most out of it. I'm looking forward to competing, winning, hopefully another SEC title, and hopefully to make it back to Omaha and win another national championship.
You know, I was blessed enough to win the national title as a freshman, and we made it back last year and lost, but, you know, we're not trying to get back to Omaha. We're trying to win it again, and we have standards here, and, you know, to win SEC titles, we've won in the past 2 years I've been here, and it's hard to do. It's extremely hard to do that back-to-back years and get to Omaha. I think it's been 4 years in a row, and to do that a fifth time is going to be extremely difficult, but we're up for the challenge. You know, like I said, that's why you come here to the University of Florida, and that's why you go through the workouts, you go through the late practices, is to end up dogpiling in Omaha.
As always, I am so excited to get this baseball season going. All those guys I got to talk to, great. They've got a bunch of great freshmen, guys coming in. The team chemistry is great, and I think they're going to be ready to roll.
And that's the neat part. You need those young guys to buy in. It's exactly what happened. It was a great fall, and heck, you're going to see three or four freshmen right in there from day one. So it'll be a young group, but a group that knows the expectations, and those older guys will hopefully get them back to Omaha. Long Beach State, the Dirtbags. Can't wait to say that name a whole bunch of times. They come to town to start off the season.
I would have to think there's some probably pretty nice golf courses out there around Long Beach State.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's a lot here in the state of Florida. And last Gator Zone, we talked to J.C. Deacon, gave you a little preview of the men's golf team. So, you know what? Let's talk to Emily Glazer and give you a little preview of the women's golf team.
Jacob Lovelace here alongside the women's golf coach, Emily Glazer, getting set for the spring. Obviously a successful fall for you guys. What did you like about the way your team played?
I just thought overall we were very consistent. You know, we started really, really strong at the Cougar Classic, and that was kind of a nice way to get everybody energized and, I think, you know, see what we were capable of doing. But then the consistency of our finishes and the play that we had the rest of the fall, I think, was, as a coach, actually, you know, just as exciting.
And obviously a successful fall for the team, but also individually, Sierra Brooks and Marta Perez getting to go to the Augusta National. How cool was that for them?
Yeah, it's quite an honor. It's going to be just a fantastic event that I think everybody's really excited about, the opportunity to be able to go up there and play, but also just knowing that the field is going to be, you know, the top 80 or so female amateurs in the world, just a fantastic field on a fantastic golf course, so quite an honor for them to be able to go and represent the Gators.
And you have some veteran leadership from Sierra and people like Martin, mm-hmm. but no seniors on this roster. How's the roster shaping up for the spring?
Yeah, that's exciting. I mean, I think because they're kind of looking at each other going, you know, we're close, we're a pretty good team, but we're going to get to play with each other like this for, you know, the next couple years. So it's exciting, but I think, you know, you look at our junior class, they're definitely our seniors. I mean, they bring the leadership and the representation that we need, you know, that leadership on and off the golf course, so we're pretty proud of them.
And some early road trips coming up in the season, going to California and New Orleans. What are you looking forward to about your team going into those matches?
Yeah, California is always a really good field and also a tough golf course. So we have some good golf courses that we're playing this spring before we really get into the, you know, the championship portion of our season. So it's not only about how you finish, but then, you know, how those golf courses are testing your skills and how we're improving, you know, each week leading up to postseason.
And it won't be long before you guys are right here playing in the Gator Invitational. Mm-hmm. How much fun will that be to play in your home course?
Yeah, it's awesome. It's always a fun week to be able to be at home and play in front of, you know, friends and family. We always get a tremendous amount of support. I think that's always kind of a turning point in our season, just an exciting time of year. Spring break, we'll get a lot of good practice here leading up to the tournament that weekend.
Well, Coach, as always, thank you for joining us, and best of luck this spring.
Thank you very much.
Looks like another really good season for the women's golf team in store, and we got to get to our first break here on GatorZone, but when we come back, you know, you're the public address announcer over there in the O'Connell Center for the women's basketball team, so I think this next athlete you get to see quite a bit of.
That I do. A lefty, too. I wish I was a lefty. It would have been better baseball, but she is phenomenal in basketball, and everybody loves her because they always sing it. Kiki, do you love me? Kiki Smith, right after this.
Gator Zone is brought to you by Wells Fargo. Together, we'll go far. And by Gatorade. Win from within.
Welcome back to Gator Zone. We're outside the Stephen C. O'Connell Center. A lot of excitement in there today as the state cheerleading competitions are going on. And there's a lot of excitement in there when you get to yell, Kiki, for three!
Yeah, I always love doing that, and she has been phenomenal in her first year as a Gator. Went to JUCO last year, and then Coach Cam swept her away, made her a Gator, came all the way down from Maryland, and we are excited that she did.
Growing up, most younger siblings look up to their older one. The case is true with Kiki Smith.
My brother, honestly, because he played basketball, so any sport that he wanted to play, I wanted to do. He played football, I started playing football. He did karate, I did karate. I just did everything that he did.
And Kiki loved playing football. She played flag for 4 years and then another year of tackle.
I was quarterback, running back, wide receiver.
Eventually, Smith had to pick which one she'd really pursue.
So most of the time, all the kids that play on the same basketball team play on the same football team. And so because I played football, we would just switch over to basketball season. And then, like, we had the same coach for everything, so we just did both. But as I got older, I realized I couldn't play football, so I just stuck with basketball.
And Kiki was meant to play basketball. First attending ASA College in New York, the Florida coaches knew this junior college player was ready for the SEC. The recruiting process was just accelerated.
But Kiki makes it easy. You know, it made it really easy to recruit her. She was tremendous on the phone. She's very, if you've met her, you know she's very personable, very engaging, and she always asks you questions in return, which is always a great, great feeling when you're the one who's asking people questions a lot. She made that process go a lot faster for us, for sure.
Smith's basketball journey started at the junior college level after back-to-back ACL injuries her junior and senior years of high school. As expected, her second time injuring her knee was harder to swallow.
Yeah, same exact one. Her way worse. That time I felt like it really hit me because I just felt like it had happened already. But eventually it worked out for the better. I got to rehab my leg better from the first time anyway, so it was fine. The hardest part was, I guess, the mental part of it, but I had a lot of family and friends to support me, so I was fine.
For those that know number one, it's not hard to see how her positive mindset helped her overcome the injuries and land her in a Gator uniform leading this Florida team at the point in her first season.
It's been tremendous to coach her, and us as a staff just love her infectious personality. She's fun, she's lighthearted, she's easygoing, but she also is a tremendous leader. And that's something that she's working on, you know, sometimes being a little bit more critical because she does have a great basketball IQ. So also being the commander on the floor as the point guard is something that really, you know, helps us. But as far as her personality goes, she brings it every day. She's always upbeat and positive, always thinking the best in people and seeing the best in others. So
the assist leader on the team has recently become quite the scorer too.
She's obviously very clearly a very talented player, and she's always been one to set the table for others, though we've been challenging her to be more productive on the offensive end of the floor, that which she's definitely risen to the challenge, and that doesn't come without a lot of hard work. So she's in the gym extra, working on her ball handling, working on her shooting, and really trying to hone her skills offensively just as much as her defensive efforts, which have been tremendous as well.
From a high school state champion who overcame two ACL injuries, Smith has found her way to Florida. This journey has brought Kiki exactly to a time in her life where she is happiest and at her best.
And I feel like I was put through all of that just so I could purposely be here. Especially because right now where I'm at, I'm happy in my life, basketball-wise, school-wise, family-wise, everything, I'm living life. So I feel like everything that had happened back in then was perfectly fine. Just for me to land right here.
For GatorZone, I'm Megan Parler.
All right, so we got to see Megan on the show anyway. Great job on the feature, Megan. And we're about to do a really great job for all of you because I think we've got a gymnastics story coming up. So can we please go inside and goof off?
Not only do we have a gymnastics feature, but then we have top plays. So I think you're right. Let's go to gymnastics on the other side of the break.
Gator Zone is brought to you by Wells Fargo. Together, we'll go far. And by Gatorade. Win from within.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Gator Zone. Jeff Cardozo, Gareth Gutierrez with you. We've moved inside now to goof off on all the gymnastics equipment. But first, we'll tell you about the professionals. And you can see how good they are. And the Gators have a really good one. Only a freshman, but she has done phenomenal things so far. Came to Gainesville all the way up in York, Pennsylvania.
That's right, Trinity Thomas, even as a freshman, has been a huge part of every single Gators meet they've had so far this year. Three-time member of the U.S. Senior National Team. So we're glad to have her as part of the Florida Gators. Here's a little bit more about Trinity.
It didn't take long for Trinity Thomas to become a household name in the world of collegiate gymnastics. She may be a new face to casual fans, but Trinity has been astonishing the gymnastics community for years. She started gymnastics when she was 7 years old, and it wasn't long before Trin developed a passion for flying through the air. Actually, it took no time at all.
I fell in love with gymnastics right off the bat. As soon as I started doing it, I knew it was what I wanted to do. And it was just something that I got excited for every day, and I was sad if I had to miss. And I think that's how you really know you love something.
Thomas is a three-time member of the U.S. national team. Needless to say, she was highly sought after in collegiate gymnastics. In fact, Trinity received her first scholarship when she was in eighth grade. Not long after that initial letter, Thomas heard from Jenny Rowland and the University of Florida.
3 long years ago, when I first came here, Adrian brought up her name, which I had already known about. I said, yeah, let's go for it. Let's see how interested she is. Needless to say, she showed a little interest.
After taking her time, weighing all her options, and she had a few, Trin finally made her decision.
We were watching it and she did a reveal similar to like at a baby shower. She had a balloon that she popped. And she popped that balloon, and orange and stinking blue came out, and I just about fell over.
There was something different about Florida, and something that really like attracted me to it, and somewhere I could see myself calling home.
When you watch Trinity Thomas, it's as if she puts you in a trance. She makes everything look effortless and easy. And she lights up every apparatus she competes on. She truly doesn't have a weak event.
Trinity is a unique gymnast in that she's extremely powerful, graceful, elegant, strong. You rarely get that combination and strength all together in one athlete. She's mesmerizing. And really, she does that on all the events. And she just really is a joy to watch.
The amazing thing about Trin is, as good as she remains grounded and humble, making her a very coachable athlete and an even better teammate.
Very open, willing to help anybody, willing to listen to anybody. She can come in and anybody will listen to her. She can go up to anybody as a freshman and impact somebody's lives on any given level.
So just how good can Trinity Thomas be?
She's on another level. I could look back, talk about other athletes and say, oh, they may be able to get a 10 on every event, maybe not one event. There is not one event that I could say that she could get less than a 10 on at any given time.
Trinity Thomas has huge gymnastics dreams and aspirations, including the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. But for now, she's going to keep chomping her way through the competition while having the time of her life as a Florida Gator. For GatorZone, I'm Shelby Grenath.
Thank you so much, Shelby. And watching that and watching what Trinity can do has made me work up a sweat. And I'm sure you as well, sure. Just watching it. So here's a little Gatorade for you.
Sweet, thank you. And fitting, it is called Cool Blue because water is blue. And that's where we go with our next story. Gosh, we are all over the transitions today. And we go from a freshman to a senior, and she didn't have to come as far, just up the road in Lake City.
That's right, Hannah Burns. She's been a big part of the team for 3 years. She's in her senior season. All sorts of SEC accolades, academics, SEC Swimmer of the Week, everything you can think of. Here's a little bit more about Hannah.
Her father played golf for the University of Florida, so senior Hannah Burns has always been a Gator. And when it came to the sport of swimming, that was inspired by family as well.
It started out with my older sister, so like I always followed whatever she did, like with sports and stuff like that. So when she started swimming, like I started swimming, and then she decided that it might be something she wanted to do in college. So it was kind of always followed her, but it was also a passion of mine too. Like I fell in love with the sport.
Burns grew up in Lake City, Florida. And even though she came to Gainesville to practice with the Gator Swim Club, the five-time state champion was not sure if UF was her school of choice at first.
Once I started getting into swimming and I started realizing like, hey, maybe I can like go somewhere and like compete in swimming for college, like I kept my options open and I wasn't ever like, I'm gonna go to UF, like that's what it's gonna be. It was always like, I wanna go other places and like take trips other places and talk to other people and like see which one was the best fit for me.
Florida ended up being the right fit for Burns and she had a successful regular season. Even though she was only one of two Florida freshmen to qualify for the NCAA meet, her first postseason did not go as planned. And it left Hannah questioning if she still had a passion for swimming.
There was like a couple weeks after NCAAs where I was like, not gonna lie, I was pretty miserable. Just like reflecting on how the season ended, it obviously wasn't as good as I wanted it to be. I hit this point where I like had to make a decision of like, I'm gonna learn from this and I'm gonna move on. And like that was probably like the biggest turning point in my career. And I had to learn how to actually enjoy it again.
I think she just needed some reminding and reassurance that you know she is who she always has been, and she is of that level. And because I think with her, a lot of it is just believing in herself again. I think that's what she needed, just keeping her going, keeping her persevering.
Hannah's mentality changed after that summer of doubt, and she blossomed into a leader this team needed in and out of the pool.
Her actions and the way that she leads and represents herself is nothing but positive. She garners a lot of respect from all her teammates as a result of that, and especially the freshmen.
As a senior, she does a really good job of leading us, not just, you know, in the pool and seeing how she swims and how she trains, but also like in just a group environment, how she leads our team. And she really does show us the culture that has been when she grew up through this program, and passing it down to us really means a lot to me. I never would have thought that I could have like taken this role. I'm very grateful to have this opportunity to do it. It's been a learning experience, and it's really, I think it's gonna help me in the future. So I'm like really grateful to have had this opportunity.
Hannah's biggest takeaway from her time as a student athlete is to never give up, even though that's almost what she did.
No matter like how hard you work, like sometimes your work doesn't show up right away. My freshman year is like the perfect example of that. I felt like I had worked pretty hard in the fall and I had done a lot of things that I felt like was right, but then in the end, the results didn't show up. But then over the next 2 years, I was able to continue working hard and the results have shown up and I've improved each year.
There was a time Hannah Burns wanted to quit the sport she loved, but she persevered and grew as an athlete and a person. For GatorZone, I'm Shelby Gernath.
Watching all that swimming going on, I think Jeff has the itch to dive on into something. So, top plays on the other side of the break as Jeff dives on in.
Welcome back. Gareth, during the commercial break, already made it in, so here is my attempt into the ball pit.
Woo!
Guess my landing was a little smoother than this guy's, so we'll see if can do better than him in top plays.
Today's top plays are brought to you by Nike.
07 against Greg Oden and Ohio State the title game. How about Keontae Johnson? Wow! Man, shot clock at 3. Turner, blind look, and it's blocked away. Shot clock violation. Florida doing it with defense again.
Second hub, bringing it all together.
One's lifted out towards shallow left center field. Base hit for Akiko Suhara, but that one was caught on the dive by Sofia Reynoso out in shallow left center field. Brilliant play by the Gators shortstop.
Jeff, I didn't get to see your dive in, but I did get to see those top plays, and if your dive was anything like those top plays, then it was a lot better than my dive.
I would agree. Way better, and we've got so much more to talk about throughout the entire spring. Remember, this is an awesome time of year. Baseball, softball, sport after sport after sport, and including this one right here, gymnastics. Make sure you support them in every way possible.
And if you can't get out to a game, make sure you follow them on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. All the Gators, all the teams are on there.
That they are. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Gator Zone. I am Jeff Cardozo. Today, he was my partner,
Gareth Gutierrez.
And props to Marshall Moyle for all the great photography work. We'll see you guys next time.